the major has to be up this end instead of being down the far end of the car park, you know. So we're going to be sort of doing it a bit left-handed. Now, as well as that, you see, with the platform where it is and the length of the band, we're going to have to make sure that our spacings are dead on, you know. And even when we're doing that, you want to make sure that you're not leaving it too narrow. Because if you leave it too narrow, you know, when they come into line, we're going to have overlap and we're going to have trouble. You know, and the best thing now we can do is to get in and form up and do it real well.
Who's going to be in the sixth draw will have to be the people that are going to be going through.
Who was in the sixth draw on Sunday?
Mary, did you ever in the sixth draw?
Yeah.
There was a row that went through.
Yeah, that's six.
And some haven't gone through before.
Oh, no, that was... Remember last Wednesday night, there wasn't enough lines, and it put us way down at the band.
You may ask, what or when was the band's finest hour? Maybe now, during these few moments of confusion and preparation, is the time to answer the question. During the Parnell split, the band, like the people and everything else in Ireland, became divided. And when Dr. Nulty, Bishop of Meath, placed the local newspaper, the Westmeath Examiner, and all who read it under interdict, the Mullingar Confraternity Band had its problems. Because, although half the band had never any doubts that they were marching to heaven, the other half, virtually excommunicated, felt they might be headed in the other direction. But eventually, peace and harmony, musically and otherwise, was restored.
Straight, you didn't get a dismiss or anything. You know, you're supposed to be there right exactly where you were before. You know, more time wasted. Now, you get back into the straight line again. Mad lads, come on, now, hurry up. Now, what we're going to do, we're going to start the routine from the beginning. You know, and when you come into that position, remember that the numbers you do the turns are 15 and 16 and 17 after that. You know, and there's a lot of you there, and when you're coming from the position here, you know, and you want to get over there, don't go like this, you know, because that's no good, you know.
And off to the International Youth Brass Band Festival at Purmerend near Amsterdam, Holland. This moment is the result of 3 years of long band practice through summers and winters, the toil and frustrations now being left behind, and the final preparations of polishing and preparing over for their visit to a foreign country and a strange people. Where one common factor will exist, music.
Your attention, please. This is the final call for flight, EI-602.
They are heading for a new world, a world they might never have seen but for the Mullingar Town Band. By special permission from Aer Lingus, the band was permitted to play at 35,000 feet over the North Sea, a height of musical achievement hardly reached by any other town band in Ireland, or maybe in the world. Appropriately, their tune was Up, Up and Away. We'll be right back. To make possible their attendance at this Holland Music Festival, the Mullingar band members make great sacrifices, saving for 2 or 3 years to finance themselves for the trip. But for these personal sacrifices by the individual members themselves, the band could never have achieved the fame and popularity at home and abroad which it has.
You're Mullingar. Mullingar and Ham Band.
Yes, I know.
You know that, do you?
I've seen it.
However, it is a happy sacrifice. They love doing it. And when they go marching and playing, the hardships are all forgotten by parents, children, and all concerned.